What's going on? My name is FreerunnerX10 and welcome to a brand new Overwatch video. In today's video, I'm going to be taking a look at the brand new event which is currently running in Overwatch called Uprising. Now, this event runs from April the 11th to May the 1st, 2017, and obviously with this event, we get a event game mode as well as an event loot box with event-based skins. And I've got to say, the skins are absolutely phenomenal. I love them. I've got a few of them and I'm working towards getting all of them. Hopefully, that's the plan. There's also free brand new highlight intros, free brand new emotes, as well as a variety of different sprays and player profile icons. Now, if past Overwatch events, they've been based on real life seasons or celebrations or events, and we've only ever had one PvE game mode, which was in Halloween, which was a lot of fun, and people requested more PvE game modes, and we got that this time round. However, this isn't a seasonal event based off real life. This is to do with Overwatch, so there's some story behind this which links into the Overwatch lore back when Overwatch was a thing. Obviously, this is in the past, so this is Tracer's first mission. It's an interesting game mode, and we're going to be playing some of it, but before we actually get into the actual Uprising game mode, we're going to be taking a look at the skins, the highlight intros and emotes that are available. As for the sprays and player profile icons, I won't be showing them off in this video. So first, let's take a look at the skins. The Uprising event comes with 10 skins in total. Two are epics and the rest are legendary. So that's a total of 8 legendary skins. And I've got to say, these skins look really, really good. So let's talk about the epics. So the first epic is for Reinhardt. It's called Lieutenant Wilhelm, and it's his, I guess, Overwatch armor uniform. So it looks blue. It's got the Overwatch logo on it. Looks really nice. Like it. Very simple, but at the same time, very good. So I'm glad that that's a thing. And then there's the Null Sector Bastion skin, which is the Null Sector is the faction you're fighting against. You're not killing like random civilian Omnics. You're killing a sort of rogue, what you could call terrorist organization called Null Sector. So they have Null Sector themed bastions, which is obviously a purple bastion, and you'll see that in the PvE game mode. So that's the two epic skins out of the way. Let's take a look at the legendary skins. So the first skin is Black Watch McCree. That is a legendary, of course. The second skin is Black Watch Genji, both of them part of the Black Watch operations with Reaper. They look pretty badass, really good skins. We've got a Chief Engineer Lindholm, which is a blue Torbjorn. He's wearing his Overwatch uniform. And then we have a orange variant of that, which is called Ironclad, which has a few things changed. We have a Combat Medic Zygla, which is a Mercy skin, looks really cool. We have a Cadet Oxton skin, which is Tracer's Overwatch Cadet skin. We also have a Null Sector Orisa skin. And then we have, last but not least, the brand new Widowmaker skin, which is called Talon. Moving on to the highlight intros, we've got a Torbjorn highlight intro called My Baby, a D.Va highlight intro called Selfie, and a Zenyatta highlight intro called Perspective. Moving on to the emotes, we have a Hanzo training emote, a Soldier 76 push-ups emote, a Pharah flare emote. So now I've shown you what this event's skins, emotes, and highlight intros look like, let's take a look at the actual PvE game mode, which is obviously King's Row Uprising, and hopefully we can get Tracer and play Tracer.
20 years after we won the war against the Omnix, we were no closer to living together in peace. The building of a new home for the Omnix in London was supposed to be the first step in improving human-robot relations. But it never had a chance. The Omnic extremist group, Null Sector, launched a surprise attack on King's Row. Hundreds were killed, and thousands more were displaced as they took control. Now, they are hunting down the last of the survivors. It could be the beginning of a new war between humans and Omnix. Unless we can stop them! Commander Morrison has sent our strike team to liberate the city. It's my first mission, and the only way to save my home. I hope we're not too late.
Wow, and with that being said, we're right into the action. I think it's only fitting that we actually play Tracer because this is her first mission. And yeah, this is a pretty cool skin. I like Tracer's new skin. Everyone's like, oh, it's another Tracer skin, but I like this one. Not too fond of the hat, but I can deal with it. I like the armor itself, so the armor's really good. I also like the dual-wield pistols. They are, I think, unique. I don't think any other Tracer... I don't think any other Tracer, like, skin has the pistols that are with this skin. So now we just need people to pick the other people. So we need Ryan, Mercy, and Torb, and then we're ready to start this thing. So this is a fairly simple game mode. I haven't played on any of the harder difficulties, but I presume it becomes somewhat impossible. But basically, you start in the King's Row underground, and you basically make your way to the sort of platform, and then you go out. And we're going to hack three terminals, and then we have to basically push a payload, kill a certain amount of bots, and then we basically win, and that's kind of how it works. It's a pretty simple game mode, but yeah, it gets harder, obviously, with the increase of the incremental difficulty, I guess, because it's like a really hard one, which I've seen, and I don't feel like doing because it's probably going to result in losing all the time. So what you need to do is go onto this point, and it's basically just a capture point, and you have to actually have one person stay in this capture point and hold it. But on the normal difficulty, which we're playing on right now, it's not like it's really, really hard to hold off this point, because it isn't. But there's also another game mode of this, which I've stated earlier, but basically it allows you to play any hero you want. So you could play McCree on this map, you could play Genji if you wanted to, you could play anything. The problem becomes is if you play on a high difficulty on that and you don't have a healer, you're most likely going to end up dying and losing. So yeah, you kind of want to be careful. So this rework of the map is quite interesting. I do like the design of this map. It's King's Row, but they've changed a few things cosmetically. As you can see, this bit, you can now like sort of like go up here and then up to the catwalk like this, which is something you can't do, I believe. I think, at least maybe you can. I don't think you can, though. Unless it opens up in one of the actual payload pushes. I don't know the maps too well. I mean, I do. I play a lot of Overwatch, so I should know that, but I don't. It's not something I look for. I go a certain direct path out of this spawn, which is like literally along that way and down there. So we're going to go ahead and go to the second terminal that we're going to hack. So basically what we're doing now is hacking. What we're doing is hacking these anti-air terminals, which have these anti-air cannons. That one there, and then we're going to go to that one inside the... Is it church? I want to say it's church. It looks like the church, a church. I think it is a church. So we have to go over there and hack that one next after defending this one and staying in the capture point. And basically what we're doing is we're taking down these anti-air turrets so that we can get a payload dropped in, which we can then use as an explosive. It's kind of a long process, and I kind of wonder what it would be like on the harder difficulties. So maybe I'll give that a go at some point. But as you can see right now, it's fairly easy because it's on normal. Normal is very easy. You can complete normal. I haven't seen anyone die on normal yet. Like, at all. So that's a good thing. That's good. Feels good, man. So, I feel like we're in a sort of pardon bit here where, like, nothing's happening. But I guess when you're on the harder difficulties, you'll have, like, loads of these null sector bots just constantly coming after you. Right now, you're noticing that we've only got a few types of null sector bots. I think it's only one type. I'm not entirely sure what these ones are called. Oh, null trooper. I should pay attention to the elimination. So, yeah, it's just null troopers at the moment. Then you get, like, sort of, like, four-legged things that are really small with lasers later on. You get, like, a big ball thing and then null sector bastions, which are purple bastions. You can also get a bastion skin for that, like I said early on in the video, when I showed off the skins. But yeah, I don't know, I really like this mode. It's a lot of fun. Oh my god, that did not do a lot of damage. I was expecting that to completely, like, one-shot that bot there, but apparently not. Okay, so we are doing pretty good. Right, we can go ahead and push in here now and start capturing the third terminal. Then we have to go over to where we get the payload on King's Row after capturing the capture point and basically wait for a payload to come in, and then we have to defend that payload while it basically uploads and initializes a program, I think. Which feels bad, man, if you're in the... I don't know when Overwatch is set, but it's obviously, like, it's a ridiculous time in the future. So I feel like at that point, things technology-wise should work and not, you know, crash and need to be re-uploaded, because that's kind of what happens. It's kind of weird. So Ryan's gonna go ahead and charge this guy, and he's down. There we go. So that's an eradicator. So these have got, like, shields, and they fire rocket launchers, which is quite annoying. I'm just paying attention to the front, which is a bad idea because they can come from the left side, because this isn't somewhere you can normally go on King's Row when you're in the church. But yeah, we're gonna hopefully do this without any catches. There we go, 92%. Should do this without a problem. So we've got null troopers, and what was the other one? I can't remember what the other one was. It was like a shock trooper, or was it... What is it? What are they called? What are you called? Oh, an eradicator. That's it. That makes sense. An eradicator. Now we're going to start to see some bastions and a big ball thing, which I'm not entirely sure. I'm not entirely sure what that's called. We have to go to this little point here, rendezvous. Here comes a payload. This is the thing that we're going to have to escort. You know, that's what you do in most payload game mode types, map things, games. Yeah, you push a payload, it's easier said than done for most people, especially in Platinum. So it's nice that you actually get to wear these skins in this mission. So say if you haven't actually unlocked the skins, you're wearing them. So everyone here may or may not have the skins. I know I have the Tracer skin, I have the Mercy skin, I have the Torbjorn skin, and the Rein skin, so I would be okay in this. But yeah, you can see that people haven't got, like, custom skins. I'm not entirely sure how it works when it comes to actually choosing your hero, because I know when you choose your hero, you can have whatever skin you want on, but I'm not sure about, like, Rein, Torb, Tracer, and Mercy when it comes to choosing your own heroes. Maybe it allows you to use your preset skin, but probably not. I don't know. I haven't played that too much, and I haven't really thought about that, to be honest. Okay, so now we've got slicers. These are little dog things on the ground, and they are basically just going to run up to the payload, and they're going to try and, well, slice them, I guess. That's what they're going to do. They're called slicers. They're going to try and hopefully slice the payload in half and just destroy the payload. So we have... what's it on? 98%? What? How did we let it get to 98? I mean, I guess it goes down a lot quicker when you're on the harder difficulty, because you'll have more, like, AI coming towards you. Okay, now we've got this big ball thing. I'm not entirely sure what it's called, but I'm going to go ahead and throw this here back out. Take some null troopers down and then do a ton of damage to that. That's called a detonator. I presume that's just a big, round, spherical bomb. Reinhardt did alright to keep his shield up there. This is a good Reinhardt. He's not charging in like an idiot. I bet he's a casual player and only plays, like, casually. Oh, there you go. That was a good charge. That was a decent charge. You need to charge them out of the way so they don't come close to you and blow up, because I'm pretty sure they are bombs. Whoa, okay. We are still 98% health on the payload, which is good. Feels good. Feels good that we're doing really well here. We're doing really well. Okay, there's an old trooper over there. What was that sound? Uh-oh. Define little snag. Okay, so basically something happened and now we've got to defend the payload yet again for 1 minute 50. and make sure that, oh, there's a Bastion, or as it said, a B73N. There are the Bastion units, but they're Null Sector Bastion units. That's all you need to know. But they are named somewhat different, and there are Arisas, but they are named differently, which is weird because you'd think that there wouldn't be anything like Arisa, because obviously FE made Arisa, but I guess there was in the past. I don't know. It seems odd. Seems odd. Anyway, okay, what do we got going on over here? Lots of problems. Okay, let's wipe these people out here. Oh, there we go. There's a Bastion here. Ryan going to pin the Bastion. Bastion's trying to self-repair. Nope, denied. Okay, Torbjorn's turret is taking a bit of damage here. Okay, I think we're good. No, there's going to be another wave in a minute or two. Let's see. We've got to wait. I think there's going to be one more push. Yes, there is. Okay, we've got problems. Go, kill the slicer, gonna stick that, blow that up, kill that, something over here that needs destroying, gonna get behind it, do a ton of damage, mercy flying in. Oh my god, what is this? Have I got a caster voice? Is that what it sounds like? I'm a caster voice. I was just thinking about what I was saying, and it just felt like I was casting a game or something. Okay, another, oh, that's not a Bastion unit, you scared me, it's an Eradicator. No troopers fall down pretty easily. I mean, this is a fairly simple PvE game mode, but I can see it being really fun when you're playing with friends and challenging yourself at a higher sort of like difficulty. Because right now it's fairly easy. Like it's very easy. It's very easy. We need to destroy this before it blows up. Oh, nice. Good job. Okay, Torbjorn popped his ult. I should really use my ults more. Okay, there we go. The payload is now working. Now we've got to push the payload. We've got to push the payload to the power plant, which the Null Sector apparently is in control of. So we're going to do that. This is fairly it's fairly simple. I also like Reaper, how he talks without the little like voice effect he has on, where it sounds like he's deaf. That's pretty cool. Also, you'll see some Bastions which are in tank mode. They're annoying. Yeah, they're really annoying, but we dealt with him. There's also a few of them coming up in a second. I'm gonna go ahead and stick that. I don't know if that didn't really do anything. It just blew off like one of his arms. I don't think he's got a shield anymore. I don't know though. He may have a shield. No, I don't think he can use a shield. I think he's lost his shield arm, so he can't use a shield. Feels good, man. Feels good. Okay, here's a slicer. Get rid of the slicer. Just reloading with tracers. It feels bad when you're just reloading with tracer. Uh-oh. Reinhardt's pushing that out of the way. Destroy it with fire. Oh, what's that? That's just a null trooper. God, when the null troopers drop in, you think there's something more threatening, but they're not. There's a Bastion. Somewhere? Where? Oh, we got some enemies behind. Oh, there he is. Oh! I don't know if that did anything. That felt like it did nothing. That literally did nothing. Reload. That literally did nothing. I literally did nothing to that Bastion unit. That feels really bad. Oh my god, what's going on over here? Oh, he's turned around. He's gained awareness. They've gained awareness. They know I'm here. Ah, problem. Ah. Oh, thank God for that. Mercy, please heal me. Thank you. Oh, it's amazing. It's amazing when people work together as a team in a PvE game mode, but not in competitive. No. Not in competitive. That's where teamwork isn't needed. That's where free DPS are, in fact, needed. Okay, so I think there's another Bastion tank on the way. Yes, there is. It hurts very much. Some slices on the way. We're on 91 HP on the payload, but that won't matter because it will be 0 HP in a second. As soon as we get it to the actual area we need to get it to. So, now we use the payload as a bomb to blast into the power plant, which, don't try this at home. You know, blowing up a power plant or trying to blow the entrance up of a power plant, not a good idea. King's Row Power Station. Here we go. Are you ready to fly? But yeah, what was I trying to say before I was really interrupted? I love Reaper's just normal voice. And like, I've got the skin of him, the Black Watch Reyes skin. And like, his voice lines obviously sound like Reaper. So that kind of feels bad that there's no alternative voice lines for him where it's exclusive to that skin. That would be pretty cool if like Genji sounded a bit different with his Black Watch one and McCree sounded a little bit younger. I don't know if that's possible to do. I mean, it's all right how McCree sounds, but yeah. It's just with Reaper, because Reaper sounds different, you know, when he's got his Reaper costume on and he's actually Reaper in the future from when he's Reyes. So we need to kill these OR-14. Oh, they're not 15. OR-14 NSs. We need to kill four of them, and then we've won. And then we've basically stopped the uprising in King's Row, aka London. AKA King's Row. Okay, go ahead and put that on you. It's probably a bad idea. That did literally no damage. Like, Tracer's ult does nothing here. Like, I could imagine this on, like, a higher difficulty that you'd be struggling and there'd be more of these OR-14 NSs. Ryan's ult literally doing nothing. Oh my god, getting booped around by these OR-14 NSs. I guess that makes sense that they are OR-14 NSs. But yeah, there we go. That was King's Row Uprising. That was Ryan's going crazy, but we won. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did in fact enjoy this video, don't forget to leave a like. Unfortunately, if you didn't enjoy this video, there's always a dislike button. If you'd like to see more content like this or more content by me, then hit that subscribe button, and I will see you in my next video.